All right, so we had a crazy weekend, guys. I hope everybody stayed safe. Before I get to any of the news, we got a lot of national media coming here to cover the Adam Toledo situation. A lot of people from outside the city, and it's a pretty big local story here. We had like protests, about 1,000 people. There was no looting or anything crazy like that, man. There was a couple stores that were broken into downtown, but they stopped it like right as soon as it happened. And I'm not sure that that even actually was in response to the Adam Toledo thing. A lot of people are talking about this situation now. For all the kids, okay, for all the kids who are out there gangbanging, doing their thing out there late at night with guns, getting blown at, shooting at other people, whatever you might be doing. Just one thing, what all the stuff that those other people are saying, like, just ignore it. This is the important thing to pay attention to. You're out there with guns, right? If the police hear shots or whatever, they have that ShotSpotter technology. I don't know if some of you kids know how this ShotSpotter technology works. It picks up the audio of gunshots. Okay, now these ShotSpotter, I don't know what you would call them. These devices, they're placed at various locations throughout the city. When they hear gunshots, okay, the police then are receive like a transmission, where the technology determines whether or not it was gunshots, or whether they try to distinguish it from other types of noises that can be similar to that, fireworks, cars starting up and stuff like that. But if they determine that it was gunshots, the police are going to be rolling to that spot pretty soon. Now, you might be out there for any type of reason. You know what I'm saying? You might be out there with your older brother just hanging out. You might just be walking down the street. There might be a bunch of guys just hanging out over there, and the ops see them and think you're with them or whatever. I mean, it could be any type of reason whatsoever. If the shots happen, okay, so the police are going to be coming pretty soon. If anything is in your hand, it doesn't have to be a gun. Matter of fact, it doesn't even have to look like a gun, like anything at all. The time to drop it is really as soon as you can. You know what I'm saying? I mean, depending on what it is in your hand, even if you have a phone, like I would put it in my pocket at that point. Like, don't have nothing in your hand when the police pull up. Definitely at the latest when you hear the sirens. Preferably as soon as the shots happen. Like, get everything out of your hands, because the police are gonna be coming, like within probably a minute. You know what I'm saying? But at the very latest when you hear the sirens, when the police actually pull up, and by that point, it's too late. You know what I'm saying? Now you're already in a tense situation. They're just pulling up, and they have to make those split-second decisions, like visualizing everything. They just heard shots. Now they're pulling up, and some of the guys on the scene have guns, some don't, and they gotta just look at everything real quick, man. And especially if you're alone with one of them in the alley, man, like, you definitely don't want to have nothing in your hands at all at any time when they're there. Dropping it at the last second like Adam did. I mean, he did the right thing at that point, but like, that's, I mean, that's rolling the dice, because you're depending on the cops' nerves by that point. You know what I'm saying? Like, especially if you're, turning around, like, you don't even want to have nothing when he pulls up, man. Like, anything, not a phone. You know what I'm saying? There's been guys got the guy shot holding garden hoses. There's been guys, shot holding like something that's wrapped in tin foil, like a Euro sandwich. I mean, any type of object, like anything in the hand, you just don't want to have it, man. There was a kid, when I was a kid, Chris Klopek. He was shot in the exact same part of the city as Adam. He was 12 years old. He had a gun, okay, but like Adam, he was out there in an alley. Police pulled up. There was no body cam. This was all the way back when I was a kid, but police pulled up and dropped him right there. Rest in peace. You know what I'm saying? So anybody, that's out there, like any of you kids. It's obviously the best thing not to be around gang members, but I know that a lot of you guys can't avoid being around gang members. You know what I'm saying? And if you're in a gang, I mean, really the same thing applies. Like, nothing in the hands when the police pull up. That's the ultimate goal. Just have the hands already in the air as soon as they pull up on the scene. They're supposed to be going back to school, man. So if you're out there like Adam is, man, obviously, I'm talking about for the kids that are just determined to be out there. Obviously, being out there in the first place is the wrong thing. I don't know if you guys heard, but that was supposedly there was supposedly some back and forth going on that night. That was what Adam was part of. There was a 2-6 who had been shot, okay, that night. And I don't know if the shots that popped up on the ShotSpotter in that neighborhood were the 2-6 blowing, or Adam and his homie blowing back at them. But somebody was blowing in that area, okay. And the 2-6, one of the 2-6 members had just been hit that night. So it was like that. You know what I'm saying? But rest in peace to Adam, man, and to all the shorties like him. Like I said, think about it before it happens. Know what you're gonna do before it happens, man, because he had like time in advance. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know those sirens, you know the ShotSpotter technology. If you didn't know before, you know now, I'm telling you. Anyways, so we had a 17-year-old girl shot, actually not too far from where that happened to Adam, like right soon after that incident. And then we had a 7-year-old girl. We had another little girl in Chicago shot and killed on the west side over the weekend too, man. And she was in the car with her father, but three people were killed and at least 21 were wounded in shootings across Chicago over the weekend. This is being reported by ABC7, and they said that a 7-year-old girl was killed and her father was seriously wounded in a shooting Sunday afternoon while they were getting food at a McDonald's drive-thru in the Holman Square neighborhood. And the father, he's 28 years old, and his daughter, her name was Jaslyn. They were in a silver Infiniti at about 4:20 p.m. at the McDonald's over by Kedzie and Roosevelt. And I've told you about Kedzie and Roosevelt before. I did a story on some girls that had stabbed up a security guard when the security guard told the girls to wear masks inside of one of the stores over there at the mall. Kedzie and Roosevelt's one of the most turned up intersections in the city. I used to always go over there for lunch. I know that McDonald's well. I used to always go over there when I would work at Marshall. It's right down the street from Marshall High School. This is in Garfield Park. That is a very hot intersection. Okay, there's that. You listen to the Chicago Police Scanner, you're gonna hear that intersection again and again. And that whole mall over there, drama stays happening over there, man. Like, I know this from personal experience being around there. We had, students from Marshall shot like right outside the school, like, on that very block. So just be advised. The girl was shot repeatedly, more than one time, and was taken by police officers to the hospital where she was pronounced dead. Her father was shot in the torso and was also taken to the hospital. His condition is serious. Now, police said that the shooting was believed to be gang-related. So less than 3 hours later, two people were shot in their car at a Popeyes in Humboldt Park, and investigators believe that that shooting and the McDonald's shooting are connected. So, I don't know what these guys had going on or anything like that, but you just know, like, the payback usually comes. They usually connect shootings, you know what I'm saying, like one after the next when they happen. So a 33-year-old man and a 19-year-old woman were in a blue Chevy Malibu having just ordered food at the Popeyes, and this was over by Chicago and Kedzie, when a gunman pulled up in the car at 7:12 p.m. and opened fire. The man was shot in his left leg. The woman was shot in the stomach. Sunday night, a man was killed and another man was wounded in a shooting in Austin on the west side. And the news keeps on proving my point over and over again. I keep on telling you guys the west side is the hottest side, bro. I keep on telling you this. The two men were standing on the sidewalk about 11:20 p.m. in the 4900 block of West Madison. That's one block west of Cicero on Madison. Very hot intersection. A male in a silver SUV fired shots. One man was 43. He suffered a gunshot wound to the chest, and he was pronounced dead. And the other man was 22. He was only hit in the leg, and he's in good condition. But you still got to get to the hospital for those leg shots because they can hit vital arteries or veins. You know what I'm saying? And let you bleed out. So people have died from leg shots. So a shooting Friday night in a Lawndale business left an 18-year-old man dead and a woman wounded. This was 7 p.m. A woman entered a business in the 3600 block of West 16th. So that's like 16th in Central Park, and began firing shots. The man was struck in his chest and face, and he was pronounced dead. And the woman was 44. She was shot in her shoulder. She's in good condition. So in some other attacks, there were two men that were hit in a drive-by in Englewood. About 9 p.m., the men 37 and 38 were sitting in a parked car over by 74th and Stewart. Okay, so you guys know that intersection. Not too far from Wugga World, someone inside a passing white sedan fired, and the 37-year-old was struck in the face and chest, and the older man was struck in the chest, and they're both in critical. So a 17-year-old girl, and this is what I was telling you guys about on Sunday, was shot in the heart of Chicago neighborhood on the Lower West Side. The girl was riding in a vehicle at about 12:50 a.m. over on Cermak. Two males exited a black vehicle and fired shots. She was struck in the head, and she's actually in fair condition after a headshot. Bless up to her, man, but rest in peace to that 7-year-old girl, man. If you got ops, you don't want to be taking your kids in the car. Take a lesson from FPG Duck. You know what I'm saying? He said multiple times he does not take his kids around with him in the car, because he knows you can't count on the ops to wait, you know what I'm saying, or give you a pass just because you're with your kids. So you don't want to have your kids with you, man, because especially if they're in a car and the ops can't see that the kid is with you, you're basically making your kid a target. if you've got beef with anybody, whether it's gang related beef or money related beef, whatever it might be. If you go around with your kids in the car, man, like, you bear part of the responsibility for your kid's death, you know, in those neighborhoods. I hate to say it like that bluntly, you know what I'm saying? I'm not trying to pass judgment on these guys, but it's a fact. You know, you got beef, you don't take your kids with you ever. Unless you're like way out in some other state or some other town, or, you know, out way out in the burbs or something like that. It's your boy Winnie City Report. I'm out.